Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Wildwood Catholic High School and our very own Mr. Wildwood Catholic. Please remain in your seats for the opening number.
Hold on, wait for the blackout.
Go!
Turn up.
Hold on,
blackout.
Oh! Oh! Oh, you can blackout.
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 You're good. Go. Just go.
Alright, just go with the music. Just not blackout.
Blackout.
Hey, blackout. There we go.
Hey. Bye, bye, bye. Bye, bye, bye. Bye, 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 bye.
Gonna start a fight. I know this can't be right. Hey, baby, come on. I loved you endlessly, and you weren't there for me. So now it's time to leave and make it alone. I know that I can't take no more. It ain't no lie. I wanna see you out that door, baby. Bye, bye.
Happy Boy Radio. We love you.
She want that loving, 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 loving. Kiss, 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 kiss. Get a smile, she fantasized about. Get it with me. They hating on me. They want to kiss, 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 kiss. Smile and so far. They can take me. She want that loving, 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 loving. That kiss, 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 kiss.
I'm sorry, let me holler at you. You so hot, 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 hot. You think I'll be hollering if you not, 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 not. Take a look around, Teddy, bend your ass down, it's in the spot, 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 spot.
Yeah.
I got money on me,
yeah.
Baby girl, no problem,
yeah.
You own this on it,
yeah.
Let's hit McDonald's, it's tea.
Tell me what your name is. I don't really care who you came with. Unless you got a couple friends look like you. My bad if my ex try to fight you. Fucked up soon as I roll in. Security better get with the program. Too deep, ain't nowhere to stand. So ain't nowhere to land. You remind me of something missing. Misses, you got my full attention. Listen, let go of the tension. If I get a minute, I'll put you back.
We'll be right back.
all he ever does is make you cry. And do you think that you can handle the truth, girl? When all he ever does is tell you lies. You know what? He kisses you, he don't mean it.
Hearing all these people talk about what's the deal with this pop life and when is it gonna fade out? Then you got to realize what we're doing is not a trend. We got the gift of melody, we're gonna bring it till the end. Come on now.
Doesn't matter what carpet drive, what I wear around my neck.
All that matters
is that you recognize that it's just about respect.
It doesn't matter
how many clothes I wear and where I go and why.
All that matters
is that you get hyped and we'll do it to you every. Come on now.
You ever wonder why this music gets you high? It takes you on a ride.
Man, I'm tired of singing.
What? I don't understand.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's your 2014 Mr. Wildwood Catholic contestants and dancers, Katie McCallion and Morgan Mulholland. My name is Joseph Jett, and I'm Mr. Wildwood Catholic 2013. And one of your co-hosts for the evening. She's not out here right now, but I'd also like to introduce my other co-host, Miss Katie McCallion. However, she's changing her outfits at the moment. You know how women are. Insert joke here. Okay. So, tonight's scholarship competition is open to junior and senior boys. We have 12 contestants this year, and they will compete in the categories of casual wear, swimsuit, talent, and the question round. Each category holds a possible 20 points for a maximum of 80 points. There is a People's Choice Award that will be awarded to the contestant who receives the most votes from the student body. Those votes are now being counted and will be announced later at the award ceremony. There will also be a Mr. Congeniality Award that will be determined by a vote of tonight's contestants. We have an experienced panel of judges that I will introduce you later in the evening, but they're right here in the third row. Following the prom fashion show, there will be an intermission and some light refreshments in the foyer, and restrooms are located downstairs. While the boys are getting ready, welcome to the stage Miss Macy Bischoff, who will be singing a song. Yeah, Thank you, Macy. That was a chilling performance. Oh, the lovely Katie McCallion.
As we move into the judging portion of the evening, please welcome to the stage our contestants and their escorts in the casual wear round. Gentlemen and judges, please welcome to the stage our first contestant, Sven Axelsson. Contestant number one, Sven Axelsson, being escorted by Jeanette Axelsson. Sven hopes to attend the Maritime Academy next year and a merchant marine in the future. His guilty pleasure is playing the cup song from Pitch Perfect. Sven's idea of a perfect date is dinner on the Golden Gate Bridge with his girlfriend Bridget.
But always keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted.
contestant number two, Patrick McGann, being escorted by his sister, Shannon McGann.
You
When Pat grows up, he wants to be a professional soccer player and philanthropist. His idea of a perfect date is laying down in the back of his pickup truck, gazing up at the stars and talking about life. Pat says he admires his mom the most because she rocks. And after joining the swim team this year, Pat realized he could breathe underwater. Pat plans on playing soccer in college.
Tyler Norris, being escorted by his mother, Tammy Norris. Tyler's role model is his grandfather, who taught him that he can do anything if he sets his heart to it. His favorite food is chili with cheese and nachos. Tyler was an aspiring hand model until recent tragedy struck in art class, and he is now unsure of his modeling future. His ideal date is a gourmet dinner on a rooftop overlooking New York City. Tyler wants to major in athletic training and play baseball down in Florida during college.
Contestant number four, Chris Roach, escorted by his sister, Juliana Roach. Chris wants to attend college for physical therapy. He wants to be just like Cristiano Ronaldo when he grows up. Chris's favorite song is Suit and Tie by Justin Timberlake, and his secret talent is being amazing at baseball. He admires his dad the most because he is hardworking, dedicated to his family, and flipping awesome.
Stand beside the ocean.
Contestant number five, Salvatore Zampieri Jr., being escorted by Mariana Papazugalou. His favorite color is the Wildwood Catholic blue, and his favorite song is the Wildwood Catholic Alma Mater, sung by Janice Schumann. Sal admires his mother for always putting up with him, his brother, and his father 24/7. Sal wants to have a future career that involves helping people.
Contestant number six, George Benjamin Cook III, being escorted by Jennifer Vodges. George's idea of a perfect date is a romantic candlelit dinner under the Eiffel Tower on a warm summer night, followed by a hotel room stay overlooking the ocean. George admires Coach Dave DeWeese because he inspired him to work hard and be a leader on and off the court. George wants to be a hashtag successful young lawyer for the DeWeese Law Firm. George plans on next year either attending Wesley or Cabrini College and studying criminal justice.
Contestant number seven, Hayden Garibrandt, being escorted by Dottie Incarvito. Hayden's favorite song is Locked Out of Heaven by Bruno Mars, and favorite food is Lucky Bones Pizza. Hayden one day wants to attend college to study foreign languages. He admires his mom because she has been there for him every day of his life, offering her advice and love.
Contestant number eight, Malcolm Darby, being escorted by Lauren Mulholland. Malcolm's favorite song is Hips Don't Lie by Shakira. His secret talent is that he can sing sweet love songs, but sorry guys, only for the ladies. Malcolm's ideal date is waking up and taking a beautiful girl to breakfast at Tiffany's. Malcolm wants to be a psychologist in his future.
Contestant number 9, Garrett Moretti, being escorted by his sister Lauren Moretti. It is also Lauren's birthday. Garrett's favorite song is Kiss Me Through the Phone by Soulja Boy. His idea of a perfect date is eating Taco Bell on the beach and then taking a moonlight swim. He admires Morgan Mahalan the most because she's Morgan Mahalan. Garrett wants to be a trash man when he grows up. Garrett wants to be accepted by Harvard, Yale, Princeton, and ACCC.
Contestant number 10, Edward Joseph McQuaid III, being escorted by Jacqueline McQuaid. Christiana Fred? Yeah. Eddie's favorite food is Chick-fil-A, and his favorite song is A Thousand Years by Christina Perry. His secret talent is the popular Olympic sport, the luge. Eddie's ideal date would be going out and shooting some hoops. Eddie hopes to be a math professor one day, and next year plans to play basketball in college.
Contestant number 11, Luke Geegan, being escorted by Maria Geegan. Luke wants to be the only person to be governor of 3 different states when he grows up. He admires NBC nightly news anchorman and managing editor Brian Williams because his early life story is very similar to his own. Luke's secret talent is being a hostage negotiator. In the future, Luke plans on opening up a small restaurant overlooking a lake.
And finally, contestant number 12, Kevin Laffey, being escorted by Morgan Mulholland. Kevin says the perfect date is any date with the perfect girl. His favorite food is fried chicken and mac and cheese. He is talented in the kitchen and a master chef. When Kevin grows up, he aims to be a father of 3 and a great husband who supplies for his family. Kevin admires his mother the most because she always taught him to grow up to be the man anyone would strive to be. One day, Kevin hopes to major in oceanography somewhere in the south or way west.
Who's next?
To say that.
Thank you, family and friends, for helping our contestants out this evening. Who's next? This is Tiff.
Okay. We're now presenting the trophy that we won on the first ever senior high night on Friday. Katie, would you like to say a few words about that?
Sure.
I don't know what to say.
Well, being the first senior high night, it was definitely
special,
and it was actually close. It was tied up until the last event, but you know, we pulled through with our Wildwood Catholic pride and energy and spirit, and
we have God on our side.
Yes. Got any jokes? How about another round of applause for our seniors?
No.
All right. As you can tell, the Boyds love punctuality. Now, you will have the opportunity to get to know our boys' personalities in the swimsuit competition. We encourage the boys to look at the swimsuit competition with a sense of humor. Our first contestant, Sven Axelsson.
Thank you, Sven. Contestant number two, Pat McGann.
Okay, let's move over.
Somewhere beyond the sea, somewhere waiting for me. My lover stands on golden sands and watches the ships that go sailing somewhere beyond.
Contestant number three, Tyler Norris.
Contestant number four, Chris Roach.
Baking pancakes, making bacon pancakes. Take some bacon and I'll put it in a pancake. Baking pancakes, that's what it's gonna make. Bacon pancakes. Baking pancakes, making bacon pancakes. Take some bacon and I'll put it in a pancake. Baking pancakes, that's what it's gonna make. Bacon pancake. Baking pancakes, making bacon pancakes. Take some bacon and I'll put it in a pancake. Baking pancakes, that's what it's gonna make. Bacon
pancakes. I think you can eat those pancakes. Contestant number five, Sal Zamperi.
The next Oceana. Contestant number six, George Cook. I'm having some difficulties.
So how about that rain today? That was crazy, right? Contestant number six, George Cook.
Yeah.
make it.
Contestant number 7, Hayden Garibrandt.
I'll say and stop.
Mr. Hugh
Sweet enough.
Hayden's idol is Captain Jack Sparrow.
Pirate's life for me. We pillage, we plunder, we rifle and loot. Drink up, me hearties, yo ho. We kidnap and ravage and don't give a hoot. Drink up, me hearties, yo ho. Yo ho, yo ho. A pirate's life for me.
Contestant number 8, Mr. Hugh Hef Malcolm Darby.
Stop. Again, that weather was crazy today. You know, Katie, you're a senior now. Where are you planning on going to college next year?
You know what, Joe? That's my favorite question.
All right.
Malcolm, ready? All right, Malcolm's ready.
Ready.
Good. Joke's already been said, but Mr. Hugh Hef Malcolm Darby.
Well, Joe, I'd like to ask you the same question. What are your plans for next year?
Next year, I plan on going to Brigham Young University, all the way out in Utah, and
Hi, it's Bobby.
Contestant number 9, Garrett Moretti.
Jump in.
I'm a Bobby girl in the Bobby world. Black and plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair.
Let's go, party.
That's his real hair, everyone.
After this, we need the blackout. Contestant number 10, Eddie McQuaid.
It's coming.
Yeah, it's coming down. Contestant number 10, Eddie McQuaid.
Keep going.
right, quiet.
Our wonderful stage crew. Contestant number 11, Luke Geegan. And finally, contestant number 12, Kevin Laffey.
Drink a rum.
Daylight come and me want to go home.
Stack banana till the morning come.
Daylight come and me want to go home.
Come Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me want to go home.
Come Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me want to go home.
Lip
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch. Daylight come and me want to go home.
As the boys get ready for the talent portion of our competition, please welcome to our stage our choreographers from the opening number, Miss Morgan Mulholland and Miss Katie McCallion. Morgan Mulholland and Katie McCallion.
"2007. Ladies, I think it's time to switch roles.
Up the roads, tonight could be. If I was always gone, if the sun beat me home, I told you I was with my crew when I knew it wasn't true. If I act like you, won't come out up in your shoes. I'm messing with your head again, just your medicine. Let's fly, let's fly.
famous. If I played you, would you like that? Have friends, would you like that? Never call, would you like that? No, no, you wouldn't like that, no.
What if I had a demon side? Made you cry? Oh, change up for one that still applies. If I played you like a toy, oh, sometimes I wish I could act like a boy. What you mad, can't handle it.
Can't be getting mad.
What you mad, can't handle it.
Can't be getting mad.
What you mad, can't handle it.
2000.
Thank you, ladies. Fun fact, they learn everything they know from Just Dance. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the talent portion of our competition. And to quote American Idol, William Hung, I have no professional singing or dancing training. I am not a professional. Contestant number one, Sven Axelsson.
Good? All right, everyone. I apologize tonight, I didn't really have a talent because my talent here at Wildwood Catholic was really messed up freshman year during baseball season. Most of you know this story. If you're in my class, you'll understand it very well. We were playing Buna, it was at the Wildwood field, and we were losing 20-0. So my coach, being who he is, he looks at me and goes, Fish, you're gonna bat. Fish is my nickname. So I walk up there, and I'm up second, I'm in the batter's box, I'm waiting for everything to happen, and Harry McNally comes up to me and says, Sven, you know, everyone struck out, it's okay to strike out. Swing at the first three pitches you see, and you'll be fine. Coach won't be mad at you because you're only a freshman, you strike out, no big deal. I said, all right, Harry, no problem. So I go up there, first pitch comes, I smacked it in the left field right over the third baseman's head. I took three steps, I tripped, and I fell. So, you know, in complete embarrassment now, I'm just sitting there and I'm wondering, like, what do I do now? Well, I'm laying on the ground, everyone's laughing at me, the ball's already gotten to first base. So, I just laid there for a good 10 seconds and I wasn't exactly sure what I was gonna do. So I just get up, take my helmet off. I took a terrible walk of shame all the way back to the dugout. Everyone was laughing and after the game, they all thought it would be funny to make fun of me and run out into left field and all trip and fall at the same time. So I'm just running behind them and I'm just, you know, I'm not enjoying it because it was really embarrassing. And that story is still told today in school. And then my sophomore year goes by, junior year goes by, I didn't do anything dumb or embarrassing. And now it's senior year swim season, we're at sectionals. And this story, no one really knows because no one told it for some reason, surprisingly, because everyone likes to embarrass me for some reason, but that's all right. So we're at sectionals, and Tim Mason is the 50 free swimmer. He is extremely fast. He swims a 24, and I swim a 27. Well, my coach mixed up our times, and he gave me the 24 and Tim the 27. So the heat I'm in is the extremely good heat. So now I'm under all this pressure to do extremely well. So I'm up on this block. Oh, and by the way, sectionals, the pool, there's two pools. So there's a pool on the left and a pool on the right, and both have their own buzzer. So I'm in the pool on the left, and, well, I heard the pool's on the right's buzzer. So I dive in, and I'm swimming extremely fast. My friend Alex is behind me. He's timing me. And long and behold, I finish. I did a 25-second 50 free. I would have won the heat. However, I look up, and all the other swimmers are still on the blocks, looking at me, wondering what I'm doing. So it was extremely awkward. And afterwards, I find out there was a girl, when I did my flip turn, that had a sign in the water that said, stop. I ended up kicking the sign, and I didn't know she was holding it. So yeah, my talent at Catholic, it just doesn't work out for me. I'm not, you know, I'm that guy that you look at if to just see a mess up or something. So this is my talent, and good night.
Thank you, Fish. Contestant number two, Pat McGann.
superstar.
Ay, qué fabulosa.
Number one, you got to raise the bar.
Kicking and scratching, grinding out my best.
Anything it takes to climb the ladder of success. Work our tails off every day. Gotta bump the competition, pull them all away.
Muscle.
Do the hustle.
Yeah, we're gonna pop, 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 pop to the top.
Wipe away your inhibitions.
Stop, stop, stop. Do the rock and strut your stuff. Pop, 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 straight to the top. Going for the glory.
We'll keep stepping up and we just won't stop.
Thank you, Pat and Tiffany. You know, Pat's a great kid. You know, he always makes my high school musical. Contestant number three, Tyler Norris. Just kidding, starting over.
Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof.
love is too high to bring me down. Can't none bring me down. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Everybody now. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Clap along if you feel like that's what you want to do. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Clap along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Oh my God, that's terrible.
Contestant number four, Chris Roach. Contestant number five, Sal Zamperi.
Not now.
Who's there?
No jet.
What's up?
For those of you who don't know, this is Becky Andrus, and she's a junior.
Sorry, stage crew.
I tell you, we did practice this once or twice.
Alright guys.
Sal Zamperi.
I'm gonna need volunteers.
Hey, hey, hey.
Let's be volunteers.
Sal, pick me, pick me, pick me.
The people on the river are happy to give. They will keep on turning. Proud Mary, keep on burning. Rolling on the river. All right.
Sal Zampieri, Sweating to the Oldies. Contestant number 6, George Cook. Contestant number 7, Hayden Houdini Garibrandt.
Thank you, Becky.
No problem.
Give her a hand. Okay. So a lot of you know me out there from whether it's school, family, friends, but a lot of you don't know. I'm actually a very talented person. You know, I can be a pirate at one time and now I'm a magician. So yeah, that's my other talent. Okay, I'm gonna ask. Okay, I'm gonna ask for a volunteer from the audience. Okay, I'll take you. Gonna ask you to stand right there. Now, can you tell everyone your name?
Alyssa.
Okay, nice to meet you. Okay. Okay, now I'm gonna ask you to pick a card. Any card. Now put it, okay, you see it?
Yeah.
You know what it is?
Yep.
Now put it back. All right, now I'm gonna do this. All right, Alyssa. Is this your card?
No.
All right, let's try that again. This one?
No.
All right, third time's a charm.
Yeah, no.
Thank you. I can.
Okay.
Now. Anyone there? Possibly.
You threw it away.
Okay, probably I did. Knowing me. Okay.
Find it.
Now, for the next part.
No.
Okay. Okay, let's keep on going. Next, I am also, other than being a magician, I am also psychic. Pause for dramatic miss. Okay.
Now,
I'm gonna. Okay, I have blindfolded myself at this time. I am going to ask you to say a number out loud into the microphone, and I will guess it. You don't have to worry about me hearing it. I can't see anything.
234.
What'd you say?
234!
Okay, it's too dark in here, but I'll try. Yeah. 234? Yes! Okay. Next, I am going the trademark trick, as I call it, pulling a rabbit out of my hat. Could you hold this for me?
Yes.
Ta-da! Now, can you just stand to that side? Yes. I don't want any accidents. I am going to make now this cup, right here. You see it? Yes. I hope.
Yeah.
Gonna make it disappear. Are we ready?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna try this again. Ta-da! Okay. Now, I promise you... Well, I can't really promise. You might get hurt a lot, actually. Gonna make you disappear now.
Okay.
Stand here. Right there. Okay? We ready?
Yeah.
Turn. Close your eyes.
Okay.
Turn. Keep on turning. And keep on turning.
Yeah.
And keep on turning, and she's gone! Now, let's just bring her back so I don't get into any lawsuits. Okay, she... Thank you, you can go back to your seat now. You've been a wonderful audience, thank you.
Boy, was that magical. Next up, we have contestant number 8, Malcolm Darby.
Awesome.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. West Philadelphia, born and raised. On the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys, they were up to no good, started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared. She said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plates had fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it. Your home's the Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cab, "Yo home, smile you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there. I could sit on the throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
Up next, we have contestant 9 and 10, Garrett Moretti and Eddie McWaid.
And finally, contestant number 12, Kevin Laffey.
No, Luke.
Oh, just kidding. Contestant number 11, Luke Egan. The youngest member of the Lower Township Recreation Advisory Board.
Why am I soft in the middle now? Why am I soft in the middle? The rest of my life is...
I won't need this. Good evening, judges, distinguished guests, show attendees, and the various municipal, county, and state elected officials that are among us this evening. our government, let me stop right there for a moment. Take note of how I use the word our and not your or my. That's the remarkable thing about our country, is that it is in fact our government. Now this government of ours, there's that word again, was based on words such as integrity, honor, and etiquette. This was not solely applicable to just the hierarchy of our government, but to society as well. Thomas Jefferson knew this. He once said, "As soon as we abandon our own reason and are content to rely upon authority, there is no end to our troubles." Righteousness to me is perhaps a foundational ingredient to any dutiful public service politician. The word righteousness cannot be defined as being either a Democrat or a Republican. It is not defined by how many financial donations that corporations or any other prominent title hands you. Whether it's voting on an ordinance, bill, or any other piece of legislation, your decision should not and must not be revolved around what's best for the sales of an industry, but rather what's best for the reason that industry even exists, which of course are the people just like you in this auditorium that make it exist. Whether you are involved in government or not, something you must never do is go against a reputable belief of which you hold most dear, regardless of any repercussions. If your heart is there, so will you be. Altering your opinion due to increased likelihood of achieving your goal is both insensible and morally compromising. If I had any advice to those candidates that have not a clue about the political world, it would be to love your elected position and to love the people that are the reason behind you carrying out that position. If you do, everything else will fall in place. There are 100 reasons and counting to run for office, and yet only one of them, just one, is the real one. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of our show.
And last, contestant number 12, Kevin Laffey.
Understand the urgency. This could be love.
Gee, that was some dirty dancing. And now, before we start the question round, we'll have another talent. She was on America's Got Talent. A senior here at Wildwood Catholic, our very own Tiffany DePaul.
That was wonderful. Thank you, Tiffany. The final judge category this evening is the question round. Each contestant will pick a question from the bowl and give us their best answer, starting with contestant number one, Sven Axelsson. What's your favorite childhood memory and why?
Favorite childhood memory? Oh man. I think probably going to grade school at Star of the Sea kind of gave me a good foundation to where I am now, and I couldn't thank them more.
Thank you, Sven. Contestant number two, Pat McGann. If you could change anything in the world, what would it be and why?
Okay, I'll answer that question in a second, but let me first start off with, and this is important, so listen up. I'm gonna say that Beyonce deserved this award. Thank you very much, okay.
Okay. Contestant number three, Tyler Norris.
Nice tux. Nice play.
Who do you admire most and why?
Well, I said this before. I'd have to say my grandfather. He is still working on roofs at JBT Aluminum, and he's 80. He's I'm trying to think. Like, let's say 83 years old, and he's 87 years old, and he's still going out doing it. And that's what I love. Like, he loves doing it, and that's what I want to do when I'm older. I just want to continue doing what I love and never stop me and just work the rest of my life.
Thank you.
Contestant number four, Chris Roach. If you were granted three wishes, what would you wish for and why?
That's a tough one. That's more like three questions, to be honest, but I'll work with it. Three wishes is always a tough one, and I guess I probably can't wish for more wishes.
No.
Okay. My first wish would probably be to make sure that Wildwood Catholic always remains open. So that everyone can experience and enjoy the privileges that I've had and make the friends and the memories that I've made. My second wish would to make sure that my family is always taken care of, whether it's medical or money, whatever the problem is. I want to make sure that my family would always have a warm place to stay, a roof over their heads, food to eat. They'd always be taken care of. And my third wish would probably be a superpower. There's many to choose from, flying or super strength. But I think I'm going to go with being able to teleport. Being a young man, it's hard to get from one place to another, since you always have to rely on others to drive you there. Mom and Dad, you do a great job, though. And when you get to my age, you get so close to your license, 12 days, that you think, boy, it'd be so much easier if I could just teleport. But those are my three wishes. Thank you very much.
Contestant number five, Sal Zampieri. What is your idea of an ideal date and why?
Well, like I said earlier in my little thing while I was walking out with my beautiful cousin Mariana, my ideal date, I would say, would be sitting on my couch doing nothing. Because I like to just kick back and relax the majority of the time, and I hope that my ideal girl would like to do that too.
Contestant number six, George Cook. If you had a superpower, what would it be and why?
If I had a superpower, it would be to fly, because I can travel all around the world.
Contestant number seven, Hayden Garibrandt. Who is your role model and why?
That's an easy question. My role model is my mom sitting out there right now, because Because all my life, she has always been there for me. She has always provided me the love that any grandparent could really just give. And I can't thank you enough for that and all the advice you give me and it's being able to put up with me too. I love you so much.
Contestant number 8, Malcolm Darby. If you could have dinner with anyone, dead or alive, who would it be and why?
I would have dinner with Jesus because he wakes me up every day to see a new day.
Nine. Contestant number 9, Garrett Moretti. If you won $1 million to donate, what charity would you donate to and why?
That's a good charity.
Oh, I already won. And why?
And why?
I would have to go to Save Wildwood Catholic because I love my school.
Contestant number 10.
Contestant number 10, Eddie McQuaid. Everyone has a mission in life. What do you think yours is and why?
I'm not really sure yet what my mission is in life, but I guess we have a family and raise them well.
Contestant number 11, Luke Egan. If you could live anywhere in the world, where would it be and why?
I would relocate to the Turks and Caicos Islands. Specifically, Providenciales. It was voted the number one best beach in the world, Grace Bay Beach. So that I believe that's my reason.
Contestant number 12, Kevin Laffey. If I looked in the dictionary under your name, what word would be used to describe you and why?
Ah, there's so many. Wow, it's a big dictionary. I would have to go with rebellious because no matter what the rules are, I always try to find a way around them.
Is that next?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. We are now going to have an intermission, but there are no refreshments, so feel free to use the bathroom, walk around, switch your legs.
I think what she meant to say is we'll have an intermission after the prom fashion show, which is right now.
All right, cool.
Okay. Now, this evening's formal wear is being sponsored by the prom committee, and they will be escorted by our own Mr. Wild Catholic contestants.
Are they ready to go?
I hope they're ready.
I can't even see them.
I think they're ready. Okay.
Okay. Do you have music?
Contestant number one, Sven Axelsson, escorting Sarah McBride.
One, you won't forget.
Reminiscent of the 1970s, Sarah's dress screams flower power. She asked me not to describe her dress with flower power.
Contestant number two, Pat McGann, escorting Sarah Jo Bauman.
You better dance, let's make a night. You won't remember, I'll be the one. You won't forget, it's going down. I'm yelling timber, you better move. You better dance, let's make a night. You won't remember.
Sarah Jo is looking foxy in this sparkly dress.
Contestant number three, Tyler Norris, escorting Morgan Mulholland.
Money ain't a thing, club jumping like LeBron now. Bold it, order me another round. Homie, we about to clown. Why is this about to go down? Swing your body round and round. And then the night is going down. One more shot, another round. And then the night is going down. Swing your body round and round. And then the night is going down. One more shot, another round. And then the night is going down.
Morgan walks like an Egyptian in this purple and gold dress. Announce it now, because we should speed it up a little bit.
Okay. Contestant number four, Chris Roach, escorting Tiffany DePaul.
Place, and maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you,
I found my place.
I see your face, and it's nothing like I've ever known before.
Love is an open door.
Tiffany is sure to sparkle the night away in this pink sequin dress.
Love is an open door
with you.
With you.
With you.
With you.
Love is an open door.
Yep.
Contestant number five, Sal Zampieri, escorting Delaney Wallace.
I mean, it's crazy.
What?
We finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me. Cheeks. Cheeks again. Our mental synchronization can have but one explanation.
You
and I
were
just meant to be. Say goodbye.
Say goodbye to the pain.
Elegant, fancy, and purple.
We don't have to.
Delaney is sure to steal the night with this dress from her closet.
Cook escorting Emily Prade.
Can I see something crazy? Will you marry me?
Can I see something even crazier? Yes.
Like a stranger in the night, Emily Prade is stunning in this dress from
Rissy Ruse.
Candlelight and champagne.
Nonsense.
It's blue, it's not even black.
Percussion.
Contestant number seven, Hayden Garibrand, escorting Carly Nichols.
Wings and words.
lost the way. She don't got a lot to say, but there's something about her.
Simple yet flashy, Carly is sure to have the time of her life at prom this year.
I wanna kiss the girl. Yes, you want her.
Contestant number 8, Malcolm Darby, escorting Kaylee Keita.
Possible she wants you to. There is one way to ask her.
Kiss the girl.
It don't take a word, not a single word. Go on and kiss the girl. Sing with me now. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, my oh my. Look like the boy too shy. You're gonna kiss the girl.
Kaylee looks like she could be from under the sea with this pink mermaid cut dress.
You know, I really ought to know your name.
I'll say the next one, it would be funny. Okay. Contestant number 9, Garrett Moretti, escorting Mackenzie Scully.
Beatrice?
Ariel?
Ariel? Ariel? That's kind of pretty. Okay. Ariel.
Now's your moment.
Reminiscing the pink ladies of Greece, Mac is the one that I want this year for prom in this short, light pink dress.
She don't say a word, and she won't say a word until you kiss the girl.
Contestant number 10, Eddie McQuaid, escorting Emily Eshgosh. Hold the phone and call the fire department. The only thing redder than this dress is her hair.
Contestant number 11, Luke Keegan, escorting Caitlin Nanos. I was supposed to say Nanobot.
You think I'm an ignorant savage, and you've been so many places, I guess.
Caitlin will spread her wings and learn how to fly in this peacock dress.
If the savage one is me, how can there be so much that you don't know?
Contestant number 12, Kevin Lappy, escorting Kimberly Garazeski.
You think you own whatever land you land on. The earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. You think the only people...
Dark as the night, yet shining in our eyes, Kimberly looks great in this dress from a store.
But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew. Have you ever heard a wolf cry to the blue-horned moon?
And now we will have a short intermission sponsored by the Disney Corporation.
And you sing with all the voices.
Thank you. This is exciting.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Oh no.
No cheers from me.
Thank you and welcome back. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce the wonderful panel of judges this evening. Yeah. First, we have Miss Chrissy Paulus. Miss Paulus is a former graduate of Wildwood Catholic who has come to us with a lot of pageant experience. She has competed, won, and judged many pageants throughout New Jersey. Miss Paulus is currently a pageant director for the Miss America organization.
Mr. John Lynch. Mr. Lynch never hesitates to offer his services to the communities and school of Cape May County. He is the director of sales and marketing for the Wildwood Convention Center. He is always involved helping multiple charitable organizations in Cape May County. In the past, Mr. Lynch has been a part of our prom and after prom, as well as consistently saying yes to being a judge. We welcome him tonight.
And we welcome back Ms. Joyce Gould. She's a Wildwood Crest resident, former mayor of Wildwood Crest, commissioner of public works, and is currently commissioner of revenue and finance. Mrs. Gould is also a noteworthy fundraiser for the Love of Linda Cancer Fund and several other charitable organizations. Thank you, Ms. Gould, for coming back to judge Mr. Wildwood Catholic. And now, for what you've all been waiting for, the results. If we could have all the contestants to the stage. Here, angle back so they can see you. You know what I mean? Like that. So. All right. People's Choice Award is given to the contestant with the most votes from the audience and student body. And the award goes to Luke Geegan. Mr. Congeniality Award is given to the contestant that most exemplifies what Mr. Wildwood Catholic should embody and is voted on by his fellow contestants. And this award is given to George Cook. And now for the categories. First up is the Casual Wear Award, with first place going to... Just kidding. There was a tie for third place with Hayden and Pat. Second place to George Cook. And first place, Sal Zamperi. For swimsuit, we have another tie for third place, Salvatore Zamperi and Sven Axelsson. Second place, Eddie McQuaid. And first place, George Cook. For the talent portion, another tie for third place, Tyler Norris and Malcolm Darby. In second place, George Cook. And in first place, Kevin Laffey. Now for the question round. Another tie for third place. Chris Roach and Garrett Moretti. Second place, Tyler Norris. And first place, Malcolm Darby. And now for the overall winners, they were so close, we're deciding to give you fifth all the way up to who won. Fifth runner-up, Malcolm Darby. Fourth, Kevin Laffey. Third runner-up, Sal Zampieri. Second runner-up, Tyler Norris. And the student who will receive the $500 cash scholarship sponsored by Student Council, Mr. Wildwood Catholic 2014, goes to... Could you please silence the baby, please? Goes to... George Cook. Thank you all for coming out this evening, and we will keep the boys up here for photos. Drive home safely. Thank you for coming.
This is your celebration.
Celebrate good times. Come on.
Celebrate.
Celebrate good times. Come on.
Let's celebrate.
There's a party going on right here. A celebration.